Welcome to my channel Lenovate. Today we will going to discuss about some of the anatomical and the histological aspects of the lymphoid tissues. The different types of lymphoid tissue in our body play a very important role in our immune system. So now we are going to discuss about the thymus, that is the first primary lymphoid tissue for the production of the lymphocytes. Now first we will gonna discuss some of the gross features about the thymus, and I have made notes of few points, some important features that you can learn easily by taking notes, and these are the few important features that we should know about the thymus. So thymus, if we see grossly, it has an outer capsule. Here you can see this outer capsule is present in the thymus, and it has a bilobed structure with the outer cortex and the inner medulla, and these are the corpuscles of the thymus that are very important for the lymphocytes production. Now coming to the points, including the primary lymphoid organ, I have discussed that this thymus is a primary lymphoid organ and important for the immune system. It is located in the superior mediastinum, above the heart, at the level of the thoracic cavity. It has two lobes that are covered by a capsule of the irregular dense connective tissue. It developed from the third pharyngeal arch of the endoderm. At the time of development, this thymus developed from the third pharyngeal arch of the endoderm. Now, it contains two types of cells. In these cells, here you can see these are the thymic cells that are present like a granules. And these cells are of two types, that include the thymocytes, the cells of the thymus, and the TECs. The Ts are the thymic epithelial cells, and they are also very important cells we will going to discuss in histological features. Also, the important function, everything has an important function in our body. So the important function of thymus include educating the T lymphocyte. What do you mean by word educating here? It is called as the maturation and making them enough strong to reacting for the immunity. That's why there are thymus that educate the T lymphocytes and then causing them release into the blood. Now coming to the histological features that we can see in the thymus, including it has the two parts, the outer cortex, that is the darker, and the inner medulla, that is the lighter. The cortex contain the thymocytes. The thymocytes, the cells of the thymus, are present in the cortex, and the septas are present that divide these cortex into a lobules. The medulla, there is an inner region, is a lighter staining and contain the thymic epithelial cells or the TECs. The thymus contain no lymphoid nodule at all. It has only the lymphoid tissue present. The important feature you have to remember for the histological point of view is that in the medulla, there is a presence of acidophilic hazel corpuscles. These hazel corpuscles are very much visible under a light microscope. Now we will gonna see how this thymus look in histological slide. So now guys, here you can see that this is showing the histological slide of a thymus of a child, because at the age of puberty, this thymus is faded with the fat tissue and not visible as much as in the children's. So here you can see this thymus has an outer darker covering called as the cortex and the inner lighter staining area, the medulla. This whitish area is the capsule of the thymic gland. This capsule is going to divide into the septa, and these septa will going to divide these cortex into the lobules. This thing is present here is showing the artery or the vein that is present in the blood vessel. And in the medulla, you can see these are the small corpuscles. These corpuscles are actually the hazel corpuscles. This is the histological appearance of a thymus. Now here you can see in the medulla, there is a presence of the hazel corpuscle that is shown large here. And this is a thymic corpuscle called as the hazel corpuscle or the thymic corpuscle. And this corpuscle is a very important feature to identify that the slide is of thymus. And this here you can see the cells present, the thymocytes and the inner medullary cells are present. There are thymic epithelial cells. So this was the general explanation and notes about the thymus. Subscribe for more videos. Thank you.